Now, Srimad Bhagavatam is the book incarnation of Lord Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam is not an ordinary book. It is non-different from Krishna. Krishna Swadhama Pagate Dharma Jnana Dibisaha Kalau Nashta Mrusha Desha Puranarko Adanoditaha. Sutta Goswami is saying this. When Krishna disappeared, what happened? When Krishna disappeared, Krishna invested all his power and he again came back as Srimad Bhagavatam. So with Srimad Bhagavatam is always there with us in the form of a book incarnation. When Uddhava, he met Krishna during his final pastimes, when Uddhava understood that Krishna is now winding up his pastimes, at that time he pleaded to Krishna, please do not go. Please do not go. What will happen? Imagine this is Dwapara Yuga was going on and you can see the situation. Now Kali Yuga is going to start. What is going to happen with the people? They're completely going to drag themselves in sense enjoyment. So my dear Lord, if you're there, there'll be some hope to revive their Krishna consciousness. So the Lord says, no, I have to go, but I will invest my power in Srimad Bhagavatam. I will come again. For to doing what? Kalau Nashta Mrusha Desha. To completely destroy the darkness. So if one takes shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam, what will happen? We will get a chance, we will get an opportunity to associate with great personalities, the great Mahabhagavatas. The Srimad Bhagavatam is a live literature. It is not a book like Harry Potter. It is not a concocted book. No, this is live literature. All the pastimes are alive. And if you want to associate with Krishna, if you want to associate with great personalities like Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlada Maharaj, Pandavas, Shukadeva Goswami, then if you want to associate with Suta Goswami, if you want to associate with personalities like Jada Bharat and Krishna's various incarnations, then you have to simply take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. There are three ways of serving Srimad Bhagavatam. One is simply by hearing from those whose life is Srimad Bhagavatam. You have to hear from such personalities and hear it with rapt attention. And then read them. Srila Prabhupada has taken a lot of effort to write commentaries on Srimad Bhagavatam. So we can take a little effort and at least read a certain portion of Srimad Bhagavatam every day. So this is the second way of serving Srimad Bhagavatam, is by reading. And third is by speaking about it, by glorifying the Lord. Glorifying the Lord, His activity, His form and pastimes amongst the association of the devotees. So this way, we can serve Srimad Bhagavatam by hearing, by reading and by speaking about it. Whenever we get a chance to speak, why not speak about Krishna? Let's try to speak about Krishna. Whenever we have some eagerness to read, why not we read Srimad Bhagavatam? So one might ask, oh, we don't have taste for reading. So again the same question, if you don't have taste for reading, what shall we do? Read more and more and more, so that we develop taste for reading. So, this Srimad Bhagavatam is a very attractive literature. It's very attractive. It attracted personalities like Shukadeva Goswami. Shukadeva Goswami, he was a muni. When he took birth, he did not undergo any kind of purificatory process. He just came out from the womb of his mother and started walking straight to the forest. But what happened? Vedavyas had a purpose to bring Shukadeva Goswami in this world, and the purpose was to spread the glories of Bhagavatam. Because Vedavyas, he wrote the Vedas, he wrote Puranas, Itihas, and distributed it to the various of his disciples to propagate the teachings. But when he compiled Srimad Bhagavatam under the guidance of Narad Muni, he could not find anybody qualified for spreading these glories of Bhagavatam. That's why he prayed to the Supreme Lord and Shukadeva Goswami was born. But now Shukadeva Goswami is born. And when he is born, he just walks straight to the forest. So now what to do? Vedavyas made an attempt to bring him back by running behind him. But it was a big failure. So Vedavyas devised a trick. He called two of his disciples and taught them two verses from the Bhagavatam and said that go and recite this in the forest. अहो वकीयम स्तन काल कूटम एंड देन वरहा पिरम नटवर वपु कर्णयो कर्णिकारम. सो दिस डिसाइपल्स दे वेंट एंड सैंग दिस टू वर्सेस ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम इन द फॉरेस्ट. एंड सुखदेव गोस्वामी हु वाज सिचुएटेड इन ट्रांस हु वाज ऑलरेडी एक्सपीरियंसिंग ब्रह्मानंद. When he heard Krishna's glories, when he heard how Krishna delivered Putana, when he heard how Krishna's form is, Sukadeva Goswami went back to those people and said, where are these verses from? And the disciple said, please go and ask our Gurudev. So he went back to Vyasadev and Vyasadev made him said, sit down. There are 18,000 verses to be discussed. So sit down. So Srimad Bhagavatam is so powerful that it even attracts the liberated souls. So what has to be said about us? A conditioned soul who are wandering around in this material world, if they hear about Krishna, will they not be attracted by, will they not become a Premi Bhaktas? Definitely. If a liberated personality who is experiencing Brahmananda gets attracted to Srimad Bhagavatam, we are not getting any ananda, but if we hear Krishna, if we hear Srimad Bhagavatam very nicely, then we will definitely be attracted and become Premi Bhaktas of Lord Krishna. So this is Srimad, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam is one of the five important process which is mentioned by Rupa Goswami. And with this wealth of this weapon of Srimad Bhagavatam, His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada traveled to the West. When he went to West, what did he have with him? Srimad Bhagavatam. What did he do there? Simply glorified the form, activities of the Supreme Lord. And these activities are so powerful, the Lord's glories are so powerful, when it enters the ears of conditioned souls, it transformed them. So Srila Prabhupada took this message of Srimad Bhagavatam to the West and he glorified the Supreme Lord, his activities, form and pastimes in midst of everyone. And when they heard this, when they heard Kirtan, when they heard the Srimad Bhagavatam, they all become attracted to Krishna and they all become devotees. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, he said that if all the books in the world are to be destroyed, but only Srimad Bhagavatam remains, the Srimad Bhagavatam is sufficient itself to give us everything. Even Vyasadev, he says, Srimad Bhagavate Mahamuni Krute Kimva Parerishvara Sadhyorudya Vridyatta Kruti Bhi Sushrushubhitakshanath. Simply by mere desire to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, mere desire. The Supreme Lord, by the Supreme Lord is willing to get bound up by the devotee. He is ready. So what happens if we hear Srimad Bhagavatam on a regular basis by making it as a life and soul? Our lives will be completely transformed. So this is the glories, and with this purpose only, Srila Prabhupada wanted that this every day there should be some hearing of Bhagavatam. Every day we discuss one purport at least. This is minimum. Just like chanting 16 rounds is minimum. That doesn't mean that we cannot chant more rounds. We should definitely be chanting more rounds. Similarly, at least the members of our Krishna Consciousness Society, ISKCON, can at least discuss one verse every day. That's why we started the system. But that we should not minimize ourselves with that only. Getting inspiration from this, we should read on everyday basis, regular basis, and make Srimad Bhagavatam as our life and soul. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.